The Deputy Speaker and Niger State House of Assembly, Senator Omaliu, the Executive Deputy Executive Council, the National Coordinator, ladies and gentlemen, before we start this meeting, sir, permit me to
of the Chief Servant of the State to inaugurate this state chapter. The ESCO of this state chapter of Women for Change in Niger State. Women for Change and Development Initiative, as you all know, is an initiative or a pet project of Her Excellency, then Dr. Patient Goodluck Jonathan, wife of our dear president, that is transforming Nigeria. As we're driving into Niger State, I saw some banners or maybe billboards that said Chief Servant supports the transformation agenda of Mr. President. It landed my heart very much, because it's not every governor that acknowledged the fact that Mr. President is transforming Nigeria. So for you to get one that clearly attests to the fact that President Goodluck Jonathan is transforming Nigeria is something to be glad about. 2010, Women for Change and Development Initiative was inaugurated when her dear husband became Mr. President. She said to herself, several first ladies have come up with pet projects as first ladies. But in my case, I'm quoting her, I want to have a pet project that will touch the life of Nigerian women, Nigerian youth, Nigerian children, especially those living under very difficult circumstances.
I've told people that if you see development, if you see stability anywhere, you will discover that the majority of the people that are behind that are women. Any developed country, you discover that the workforce, 60% or more, are women. In terms of working generally, you are doing exceedingly well. But in terms of others, again, I think you are your own enemies. Women, although it's common sin, is in our nature, but I think you need to do more. And I'm happy with this woman for change, the way you put it. You need to do more so that women can understand nobody can take away that which is ordained for you. And we need more of your organizations so that, like in the prayers of Rachel, where she was talking about women give birth to presidents and co, and I whispered to the deputy chief Sawan and I said they also give birth to robbers. We need organizations like yours to be able to educate other women of their roles, of what they can do to develop the family. You need to educate the women so that they can understand their rights and privileges. It is very important that women go around looking at themselves as objects, and for men to see them only as object of entertainment. Yes, like we said, we may not be equal, but each one of us must understand the role that we should play in the society. If you see a husband smiling and happy, it's very, very likely that he enjoys the home front. If you see a man frowning and not happy, fighting all the time, go and find out, you will discover that his house is not in order. And particularly in the political field, I will urge you to do more. You are the most reliable people, at least in terms of commitment. Whatever you do it right. So you must really encourage girl-child education. We must educate our children so that as they grow, they should be able to do more. And like you said, yours is not only the urban area. We must go to the rural area where the women are suffering. You must also encourage us to keep the peace, because whenever there is no peace in any place, you suffer the most.
Wow. Shows. to our ward and unit level. This initiative is an initiative that intends to touch the lives of women, change the lives of women, bring development to the lives of women, and impact positively on the lives of women.
Women and girl child. Upon becoming the first lady of this country, that is, my husband becoming the president, her major concern was, how will I better the life of the young women?
What is the problem?
There are so many other options staring her in the face. As she said, I want to touch the life of the young women. And that's why in 2010, Women for Change and Development Initiative was birthed.
The representation of women in decision-making positions in the United States has improved since the beginning.
soldiers of climate change and energy in the United States. I'm the woman of the nation, the first lady, the Grand Petal Initiative of Climate Change and Energy. I want to bring this gift